Dear learners, now let's understand what is VED analysis. So before we understand what is VED, the main part here is the criteria used for VED analysis is the criticality of the products. Now there are certain inventories which may be negligible in the cost, but they are vital in the production process or in the assembly process or to run the plant operations. So these are the inventories which are important by their absence than their presence. If such inventories are stock out, it has a direct impact on slowdown of the production or even idle mode of workers or machines in the assembly line, and which includes stock out or penalty cost due to delays in the order fulfillment. Now, VED stands for vital, essential and desirable. All those three definitions shows criteria of inventory classification as a criticality of the product. Now let us understand what is V class, E class and D class products. So V class products are, these are the products without which there is a high loss in production or assembly process, and assembly or production can almost stop. So without these products, the assembly and production can be completely stopped, and that's why they are considered as a vital product. So absence of V class product is a highest risk in the manufacturing environment. The second class of product is E class product. Now this is the product without which there may be a temporary or moderate loss in terms of production or in terms of assembly line, and that's why these products are referred as essential. And that's why absence of E class product is a moderate risk in the production or assembly line. Now what is D class product? So D class products are, these are products which are required, but they are not creating any immediate cause of production stoppage. Hence they are referred as desirable product. And hence absence of D class product is usually a tolerable risk for the businesses. Now let's understand the example of V, E and D class. Now as far as vital products are concerned, let's consider an example of hospital industry. So in V class, there are products like life-saving medications or specialized medical equipments which are required for critical procedures of the patient care. And we can also consider essential surgical tools that are providing immediate medical attention to the patients. And without these products, it will be a high risk for the patient's life. We can take a simple example of COVID pandemic situation, that remdesivir injection was one of the major required injection for the emergency patients care, and this injection was actually helpful to avoid the risk of the patient's life in the COVID situation. Now in case of essential products, these are commonly used pharmaceutical or medical supplies which are required for routine treatments and routine patient's care. It may include bandages, syringe or even antibiotics, and without these products, a quality of treatment will have a direct impact. Though it will not have a direct impact on patient's life, but the quality of treatment will be completely impacted. The third class is desirable. Now, these are the products. It is basically non-essential items that may enhance patient's comfort or it may improve service quality. So, such products in the hospital industry can be decorative items or certain luxury medical equipments or even specific branded products which gives a major comfort to the patients. So those are not having direct impact on patients' treatment, but that will actually improve a service quality. Now, as far as another example is concerned, let's consider an example in automobile spare parts industry. So vital products are those products which are critical spare parts, which are required for emergency repairs of the vehicle. Or these are safety critical components such as brake pads, airbags or even engine parts. So that becomes a vital product. Now in essential products, these are basically regularly demanded spare parts for common repairs, and these can be also used for the maintenance. So such products may include filters or belts and even batteries of the vehicle. In terms of desirable category, These are optional accessories or specialized spare parts for customization or providing a luxury feature in the vehicle which have limited customer demand. Now, as far as use of VED analysis is concerned, so VED analysis helps more into designing purchasing policies and stocking requirements of the products.